what the law, the bill and the law clearly states is that the medical exemption is at the professional judgment of the physician. We took amendment to absolutely clarify that point.
One of the things we've talked about over and over again is how important it is that there be a strong and robust medical exemption so that anybody who has a legitimate medical concern, genetic predisposition, some sort of immunological problem, they can go to a doctor anywhere in the state and get an exemption from that doctor. That's very important to me.
If a physician feels that there's a genetic association and a sibling, a cousin, some other relative, it's not safe for the vaccine, they can provide a medical exemption for that vaccine. There's no limitation. It may be family related, that therefore that child is also at increased risk, even though that child has not yet suffered harm. Then they can exercise their professional judgment to provide an exemption.
Now, as you know, the committee has offered several amendments that we're very happy to accept. They mainly relate to expanding the medical exemption, and that's something that I'm very interested in.
What they have to do is document the reason. They document the duration, which can, and there's no limitation to that, it could be indefinite.
And so it's important for me that doctors not be sanctioned, not be impacted for exercising their discretion in granting a medical exemption.
We've just heard from the medical board. We are not aware of any physician who's been disciplined and investigated because they provided a medical exemption, so there's no cloud hanging over them. There's nothing in the law that says that they cannot. They are perfectly free to do that, and physicians have done that before. You know, we are trying to create the space to allow doctors and their patients and their parents to work together, hand in hand.
A law passed 2 years ago was supposed to reduce the number of parents opting out of vaccinations for their kids. But ABC 10 News Investigates has discovered parents are still finding a way to avoid vaccinating.
The purpose of SB 277 was to protect the public.
The medical exemption in and of itself is not a loophole. The question is whether the wording of the law and the offering of the medical exemption might have therefore created some unintended consequences.
The bill was not about the child who is not being vaccinated. The bill is about protecting people in the school.
I'm sorry.
Yes, please.
I would like to just put a slightly different perspective on that. That as a physician taking care of a patient, my primary responsibility is to that patient. I want that patient to get the best medical care. I want that patient to be the healthiest.
Now doctors say that law is not tough enough.
There's a very small number of physicians who have basically betrayed their professional oath.
Senator and Dr. Richard Pant says those doctors are manipulating the vaccination law he wrote, writing unnecessary or improper medical exemptions to allow children to avoid getting their shot. But the California Medical Board says it has opened investigations into close to 50 doctors who may have written invalid medical exemptions. He's now working with the medical board to help crack down on the rest of them.
When you have a physician acting unprofessionally and allowing other families to evade the law, someone needs to be able to represent the public and say that public health requires that we not allow inappropriate medical exemptions.
Now, the medical board says it can revoke a doctor's license for improperly issuing a medical exemption. It hasn't had to do that yet, but Dr. Pan says he plans to continue reviewing the data as well as his tough vaccination law to consider whether it needs to be rewritten.
Any thoughts or updates on child immunization in our schools in light of our recent law? Are we closing the gap of non-vaccinated youth in our communities?
We are clearly closing the gap. The one piece that we haven't closed is the ability to investigate, unfortunately, some fraudulent physicians who, for financial gain and philosophy, are writing medical exceptions inappropriately, and we do not have the authority to investigate of those issues. I did turn one physician into the medical board, but even they had quite limitations on what they could do to deal with this issue. In spite of that, we are bringing up our vaccination rate even in those schools where there have been some philosophical difficulties in getting the vaccinations up. But that's the big loophole that still exists.
Thank you. And then is that reflective of statewide?
Yes,
data.
Statewide, we see a very similar pattern. We're very pleased that last year we saw a significant improvement on the number of children that are immunized and a reduction in the number of families that were exercising personal belief exemptions, a significant reduction on the conditional admissions to school. We are preparing the data for this year. It should be out very soon. I think you will all be pleased with some of the continuing trend with improvements in those areas. But Dr. Leff is correct that as we see improvements in those areas, we're beginning to see some encroachment on the number of medical exemptions that really, in our opinion, frequently don't have enough merit. So that's something that we're watching very closely.
Thank you. And I think at another time, I want to thank the chair for his leadership